Hello everyone, myself Khushbu, and today we'll be talking about the human digestive system. We all eat food. What do you think about the food which we take? It is digested so that energy can be liberated to perform all the life activities. The mode of the nutrition in the animals is holozoic. It is accomplished in following steps: ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and digestion. Let's talk about these steps one by one. The first one is the ingestion, in which the food is taken in. The second one is the digestion, where the complex food material is broken down into the simple soluble forms. Then is the absorption. The digestion is done. Now these nutrients will be absorbed by the blood and the cells. Then comes the assimilation. They are joined together to form the carbohydrates, fats, proteins, etc. Whatever is left behind, that is the undigested part of the food, is liberated out during the process of digestion. Now talking about the human digestive system, the organs which participate in this process of digestion are termed as the digestive organs, and they are present in the form of alimentary canal. Beginning first with mouth, then comes the esophagus, then stomach. Stomach opens into small intestine, large intestine, and finally in the anus. Now, how this process of digestion is occurring in these organs, we'll be talking about them one by one. First is the mouth, or we call it as buccal cavity. Whatever the food we take in, it is masticated, that is broken down into the small pieces with the help of our teeth. Then it is mixed with the help of our saliva and tongue. Then we swallow the semi-solid paste. The semi-solid paste which we swallow is known as the bolus. Mouth opens into the esophagus. Esophagus is a muscular tube which is of 25 to 30 centimeter, and here no digestion occurs. Only there is the rhythmic contraction and relaxation. This alternate contraction and relaxation is termed as peristalsis, and by this peristaltic movement, the bolus is then transferred to the stomach. So, esophagus is a connecting link between the mouth and stomach. The stomach is a J-shaped organ. The stomach is a temporary storage house for our food. In the stomach, there is acidic environment because of the presence of the hydrochloric acid. The stomach is liberating the juice, that is termed as the gastric juice. It contains a very important enzyme that is termed as pepsinogen. This enzyme is inactive. Now, with the help of this acid, the inactive enzyme will be converted into the active form, that is pepsin, and it digests the proteins into the simpler forms. Now, the whatever food is digested in the stomach passes to the small intestine, and that is called as the chyme. Now, the small intestine is termed as small because it is only 1 inch in diameter. The small intestine can further be divided into duodenum, jejunum and ileum. Maximum absorption of the food occurs in the small intestine. In the duodenum, it receives the digestive juices from the accessory gland, such as liver. Liver secretes the juice termed as bile. The bile juice helps in the emulsification of the fat. What do you mean by emulsification? It means the breakdown of the fat into fatty acid and glycerol. Now, the liver is secreting bile, but it is storing in the gallbladder. Now, coming to the pancreas. The pancreas is a leaf-like structure, and it also secretes the digestive juice, that is called as pancreatic juice, that is alkaline in nature. So, environment in the stomach is acidic, but in the small intestine, it is alkaline. Now, all the juices will be acting in the duodenum, and there will be the digestion of carbohydrate, proteins and fat, and maximum absorption occurs because it contains microvilli. These microvilli are the finger-like projections which are richly supplied with the blood vessels. Whatever digestion is left behind, it will be taking place in the large intestine. The large intestine is divided into cecum, colon and rectum. Absorption of water also takes place in the large intestine. In the rectum, the undigested food is stored in the form of the fecuses, and then it is passed out of the body with the help of the anus. The human digestive system, beginning first with mouth to anus. Digestion is a process where complex food material is broken down into the simple soluble forms. Now, I hope you understood what happens to the food that we take and how it provides us with the energy. Thank you so much for watching this video.